So I enjoy. By the way, stop touching me, guys. Stop touching me. The reason they are afraid of John 17:3 because that is an explicit statement.
We are no way.
The explicit statement in John 17:3 says, "This is eternal life
and the Messiah.
This is eternal life that they may know you, the only true God." Now, if Jesus is saying the only true God is the Father, who are you to dispute? Okay, there you go. So, we are clear that according to Jesus, the only true God is the Father. The reason he doesn't want to engage in that discussion is because he knows that the statement that Jesus makes is about his and about anybody else's, according to their belief. Okay? Now, if these human worshippers are going to tell us whom to worship, we don't want to believe that. Because Jesus did not worship a human. Jesus has a God. Who is the God of Jesus? Definitely not anyone other than God Almighty. If Jesus worships a God, then you better worship the God of Jesus and not Jesus. Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum.
Hey guys,
by the way, why does he want to discuss John 17:3?
Why?
Because he knows he cannot answer that.
What? We are discussing
John
8:15.
Are you going to engage? Are you going
to
preaching again?
So you ask me a question and then when I answer you.
No, but you're not answering my question. I should answer yours.
No, because I have to preach.
What question did I ask? Because you.
What question did I ask?
Can you answer my question?
You said.
You come here to preach or to answer?
You said. Okay. You're not going to answer.
John 17:3. Can you answer? Can you answer John 17:3? No, you're scared.
I'm not scared.
You're scared. So answer that. What does it mean?
Why should I answer that?
Because that is going to be against your.
No, answer my question.
What? What is your question?
My question.
Will you answer mine after that? Will you answer my question after that? Will you answer my question after that? No, no. Will you answer my question? I'm not asking you. Will you answer my question?
Let's talk in a civil way.
Okay. In a civil way, will you answer my question after? Okay, so basically, you don't want to answer. You want to preach here? This is not the church. If you want to preach, go to the church. Because over here, you get questioned by Muslims.
So, don't push me, no need for that. Calm down.
Calm down, don't push.
This is the aggression that I showed.
Oh, here comes the violin now. This is aggression. So John 17:3, Jesus says, this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God. No wonder you don't want to answer that question. Because the questions will always go by what is implicit. And they will reject what is explicit. The explicit clearly states, the only true God is the Father. The Father, according to them, is the God of Jesus. If Jesus has a God, then why do you worship Jesus himself? Very clear, very simple. Is this text still stuck on the I am? It is ambiguous, absolutely, you're right. Because you see, ego emi was also used by Paul. The reason he doesn't want to
eat Hebrew even says I am. So the reason I'm not going to answer your
what about
question.
Paul? Listen, what about Paul when he said
listen,
I am?
The reason,
I don't want to listen if you don't answer.
So he asked a question and I'm saying
but you don't answer my questions. Why is that?
Because you came here and you were talking about
I can come here, the speaker's phone. Maybe it's your first time.
So
it's
not my first time.
Good, so you know what engaged then?
Me and him were having a discussion, right? So you came in, interjected, started shouting. And then, so we know.
Are you not shouting? Are you not shouting?
I'm only shouting.
Well, you are shouting. Thank you for
joining. So anyway,
practice what you preach. If you don't want people to shout, anyway, don't shout.
So I'm not going to answer your question because I'm in a discussion with him on a different topic. And you're going
to the same topic.
You're coming to me with a completely different.
No wonder you're scared. Okay, anyway, if you don't want to talk, you can move away.
So if me and him are talking,
that's fine.
And he comes and
starts asking me different questions. I know why you're scared.
Why should I answer?
Because John 17:3
and then when I say I'm not gonna
is a kryptonite exactly for the Trinitarian. Jesus believed and worshipped a God.
So, but you,
and you should not worship anyone other than the God of Jesus.
Even though you have come to me, you still have not answered my question.
Will you answer mine? If I answer yours.
Why should I answer your question? If you've come to me and started asking from
don't make rules. You don't make rules here.
So what I'm talking
you don't make rules here.
Okay, so you're just gonna come to someone and ask them completely different questions.
No, it's the same question about ego and me.
So we're asking, he's asking me about John 8.
About what?
John 8, 15 and 59.
Is it about ego and me?
And Exodus 3:14, in which I have shown you in Hebrew and King James Version where you are wrong, and then you come to me and try to change the topic because you are scared. And I'm saying, let's not change the topic.
I said ego enemy.
Listen, listen. Maybe I said let's not change the topic.
Yeah.
Because you understand that you have been stumped in that department. And now you're trying to change
stumped.
The topic.
Which yes. topic am I stumped about?
So I've shown you in Exodus 3:14 in King James Version and Hebrew what where it proves my point.
Which is what
you,
is your point?
You showed me.
Okay, what is your point?
You showed that Jesus used the same chance that God used to convert himself.
Okay, but was Jesus Almighty God?
Jesus is the Almighty God.
Doesn't Almighty God have a God?
And I've shown you.
Doesn't Almighty God have a God?
No.
Did Jesus have a God?
There was three in one.
So did Jesus have a God?
Three in one.
Very simple question. Did Jesus have a God?
Jesus does not have a God. Jesus is God.
So you're saying Jesus was like
Father? It's not 1 + 1 + 1. It's infinity plus infinity plus
that's
infinity.
Not in the Bible.
Because what's okay, Jesus? God eternal.
God is eternal, yes.
Yes. So what's eternal times three?
Eternal times three. You don't
it's
multiply
eternal.
Yes. Which matters
so
that?
When
who multiplies
not,
eternal?
It's not three in one. It's eternal, eternal, eternal. Which is eternal.
Did Jesus have a God? You said no.
So, when
so you're lying now because Jesus himself said he had a God.
You said that Almighty God.
Whom should
have
I believe?
God.
You or Jesus?
You said that Almighty. You didn't
I'm
say
sorry,
Jesus
you said not
God.
To shout.
You
talk
said.
To
you
me.
Said. You
calm
see,
down.
As soon as I disrupt it, you try and say why you're shouting.
You said Jesus did not have a God. Am I right?
You said that Almighty God have
did
a
you
God.
Say yes, yes? Did
yes.
God have a
and
God?
And I say that God does not have a God because God
no,
is.
No, my question was
listen,
did Jesus
listen,
have a God?
Listen, listen, listen. God is something that you believe created you, right? So therefore, something to have a God is saying that that created that.
Does Jesus
therefore,
have
I'm
a
not,
God?
I said that
my question.
Almighty God.
I'm shouting,
does
calm down.
God.
I know you're triggered.
So I'm
calm
triggered.
Down. You are.
So as soon as I disprove his point, he's not saying I'm
what,
triggered.
What, you don't disprove
I him. You guys are
my
no
question
debating.
Was, did Jesus have a God? See, you're preaching again. It's not the church.
I have told him.
Maybe in the church you preached on your
I have proved him wrong.
No, you
and
haven't.
Now he's attacking me.
I asked
character.
You, does Jesus have a God? You said, no, he did not.
You
but
said
in Jesus.
Did Almighty God have a God?
Look, let's talk.
And I said
let's talk.
Almighty God
you talk
have a God
and then I'll respond.
Because God okay. is suffering.
You asked me a question and I'll respond. God. What was your question?
And
what is your question?
God cannot rule over a God.
What is your question?
My question was related to John 8:57.
What about John 8:57?
In that Jesus used.
Whether it's John 8:48, yeah? Not John 8. You even forget your own Bible.
No, it's John 8:57.
John 8:57, so it's a different topic.
No. Different topic. You were on that topic originally.
Okay.
So
by the way, I asked you, does Jesus have a God? You said
no.
No,
no, no.
Am I right?
Look,
you said
I said that an Almighty God does not
no,
have
does
a God.
Jesus have a God? That was my question.
I'm saying that Jesus is God.
Does Jesus
and
have a God?
God does not have a
look,
God.
It's a simple question.
We
can
were,
you please answer?
No, no,
does Jesus
we on,
have a God?
So look, so you were wrong. It was John 8:57-59.
Okay, what does it say?
It says Jesus said they said thou art not 50 years old. And hast thou seen Abraham? Jesus said unto them, verily, verily, I say unto you, before Abraham was, I am. And we know in Exodus 3:14, according to the Hebrew, which you have shown me, I've actually lost now, and the King James Version, that is the same title that God uses to refer to himself.
What is the
it
title?
Says,
can you repeat the
I
title?
Am.
No, it doesn't say just I am. Look, here's the title.
I am. Okay, look. Read this. Read
God
this.
Said to Moses.
Yes, read it all.
I am who I am. Not
read
just
it,
I am.
Read it all. Read it all.
Why
read it
calm
all,
down.
Read it
I will read all. But first, let us confirm
read
one.
It all. Read oh, it all.
I will read all. Calm down.
Because in the verse, it says I am as well.
Wait.
Read this whole
wait,
verse.
Wait a minute. Wait a minute.
But read this whole verse.
Why didn't you read this bit? What does
okay,
it say?
God said it to Moses. I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me to
okay.
you.
But
I am has sent me
shouting,
to you. So in
down.
The same verse, it is also saying just the words I am, indicating that itself is a title.
Now read the footnote.
He is not. Wait, listen.
Read the footnote.
He is not using that because he knows
we're
that.
We're preaching all the time. Read
the
footnote.
Says,
what does the footnote say?
The point says, or I will be what I will be.
So there's no I am there.
It says
in
I
the
am
footnote,
there.
No I am.
It said,
because that is a Hebrew translation.
Or, when it says all, what is it referring to?
All means there's
or,
two.
All is referring
wait,
to
wait a minute,
I
calm,
am who I am.
Calm down.
Or I will be who I will be.
Okay, so
it's, listen, it's not referring to the second point in the verse where it says, I am has sent me to okay. you.
So what does that it mean I am? Where does it say I am means God? Where does it say I am?
Look,
where does it say I am mean God?
God says to Moses, I am who I am. This is what you are to say to the Israelites. I am has sent me unto you. We know that I am is God because who else has sent the Israelites to them? You? No.
Who sent Jesus?
It's
okay. Who sent Jesus?
Wait, no, no, no. Go to this verse.
Oh, why are you?
No, go to this.
Every time I have to answer.
Now he's trying to disrupt it. I have shown you where it says I am exclusively.
And
it
also says
he said that
he will be where he will.
Yes.
It's not just I am.
Listen. So it's not just I am.
Yes.
Just because, it's not just I am. It doesn't mean that it's not I am.
I didn't say not I am.
Yes,
I said
so
not just I am.
Therefore, I am there.
Who I am, or I will be where I will be.
Yeah, and then okay, it says, wait, I am has sent me to you. Indicating now, that now I am
have,
is a title.
Have you dealt with
Jesus
that?
Then uses the term, I am. Jesus said that I am, right? Indicating that is the same title that Jesus said.
It's not the same.
What
title.
You are saying that
I am who I am is not the same
let
as.
Let me finish.
What he is saying
is that because Jesus said, because the Bible also said, on top of that, I will be what I will be. It is destroying I am. It's not saying
it
that.
It is actually.
It's not.
It is because
so
the reason for that is because
you see,
when
you,
Paul
you,
says you, I am in the Bible, you know how
so
to translate it.
Cameras look.
I am He.
But this is the Old Testament.
Same.
Look,
ego emi.
Because even in the Hebrew, it says, I am, I am.
Okay.
So, look, in he's, first of all, he also said that it's not in Exodus 3:14. And he also tried
to
describe
it saying
Exodus.
Just, I am, it's I
he
am.
He said it was
Exodus
from
that is the title.
3:15, which I don't know.
Esher, Ahyeh. That is
he
the
also said it was John 8:47, which was also wrong, so I don't know where his knowledge is coming from.
Okay.
Clearly not the Bible.
You know, earlier,
anyway,
earlier
that's,
when
that's
I,
not point.
You remember
that's
I said,
not point.
Remember, you're going to run away now, isn't it? You're going to run away.
So
earlier,
listen,
you said that
now.
Jesus did not have a God. Am
no,
I right?
Wait, so now he's changing it. Answer this. Look, it says,
we've dealt with I am.
No,
we've dealt with
that. I said that you're wrong.
No, I don't.
Okay, how are you
I
not
don't.
Wrong? Because here it says,
if you don't let me speak, then there's no
Moses,
point.
I am that I am. And he said, thou, and he said, thou,
by the way, they won't be able to see
say
your
unto the children of Israel, I am. Has sent me unto you. I am
but Jesus
the title
said,
in bold.
Jesus
says,
I have not
you.
Come by my will, but by the one
we are
who
not
sent
onto
me.
That.
So who sent Jesus?
We are
another
not
I am?
That.
Another I am? How many I ams are there? Is the Father I am? Is it Jesus I am?
The
is the Holy Spirit I am?
Yes.
How many I ams are there?
That's the thing. You're proving
so
the Trinity.
So in English it'll be we are.
You're proving that you just proved that
there's no Trinity in the Bible.
Because he
there
said
is no Trinity.
He accepted that all three of the or he said that he accepted that multiple people said I am. And then now he's saying, does that mean there's three?
Okay, now read
and
this.
I'm saying that that's the whole point
read,
of the Trinity.
Read this.
So
are you gonna run away?
He has proven the Trinitarian doctrine.
Are you gonna run away now?
By trying to mock
okay.
it.
By the
he
way,
said,
if you want
said,
to run away, that's
then listen,
fine.
I need to go, but
of course you have to go. When they're going their stuff,
he tried to mock
now,
it.
Now you know this
listen,
is the bit
he tried to
this
mock
is the bit he ran away from. Now
he
this is eternal
he
life.
Said, he said
that they know
oh,
you.
People say I
the
am
the only true God and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent.
He said,
that
oh,
will run away.
People say I am.
No wonder we run away.
Mock, but he said, that is what I'm saying.
That's why he runs away.
People say I am.
You know what? I worship the God of Jesus. These guys worship.
Run away, bye bye.
Can you please explain this? Hashim,
okay.
Can you explain me something?
No, I'm not talking to you. You're a,
can you please
you're a filthy man.
No, sir. You're Muhammad as a filthy. Look at you.
You're a filthy man.
No.
Why are you running away now? You said you'll give me a chance to question. But you lied to me. You said you're going to ask me a question. You're letting me going to ask you a question.
No, I didn't say that.
Oh, so you lied.
I didn't say that.
So you lied.
Okay, bring out the recording. You guys go back to
John 73 is a kryptonite for Trinitarians. No wonder you ran away. Because you know why? You
don't
never find.
Can you please explain this?
I know you're going. What happened?
I need to go home.
John 73, go home and read it.
Pardon?
Go
okay,
home
read,
and read,
read
it.
Exodus 3:14 or 3:15 according to his
according
knowledge.
To the Jews.
And John 8:47.
By the way, why do the Jews, why do the Jews reject Jesus?
8:57.
Why do the Jews reject Jesus?
Because he claimed that he was God.
No,
thank
because
you.
He was a man. Man cannot be God. Thank
yes.
you. Look
so
at here.
He said man cannot be God. Look at here. Look. Look, this one is proven.
Man cannot be God. Thank you.
Can you please explain this one?
Okay, so they worship a man.
Look at
here. We worship the God of Jesus.
9:31. Look at here.
Can we come here? Let the dog shout there.
Look at here.
No wonder Jesus called. You know what Jesus called the Gentiles like him?
They
dogs and swine.
They took,
do not give what is holy to them.
They took
guys
their
like
rabbits.
Him.
Look at here. They took their rabbits.
Do not give what is holy to dogs and swine.
Beside Allah and the Messiah.
Guys,
look at here. Can you explain this one? Look at Hashem.
I don't want to talk to you.
Let us conclude.
That boy was very obsessed with the I am verse. Okay, now let's get one thing right. You know, whenever the New Testament has the term ego emi, yes, it's used in the case of Paul, it's used in the case of a beggar, yes, and it's used in the case of Jesus as well. Now, this is the double standards of the translators of the Bible. Whenever they see the term ego emi in the case of Jesus, they translate it as I am. But when it comes to the Paul and the beggar, they translate it as I am he. Now, this is clearly showing you the double standards that they take. They say the title I am only belongs to God Almighty. So why is the beggar using it? Are you telling me the beggar is also God? And the angels and Paul as well. Now, I am is something which is used as ego emi. It's never translated as something God Almighty or anything like that. Not once has it been translated.
Pagan, Hashem, you're a pagan.
No wonder Jesus says, do not give what is holy to dogs and swines. You see how they bark? That is the reason Jesus calls them dogs. That is the reason. See? Barking. That's what they do. Guys, can you turn your camera and show an example of Christian? This is Christianity. Jesus calls them dogs and swines for a reason. Because they trample what is holy under their feet.
Can you please explain this one?
Okay. So anyway, Jazakallah khairan. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
Pagan.
Dogs and swines.